the most powerful motivational speeches that I have ever heard came from people who told me I couldn't do something. You know why? Because when they told me I couldn't do it, I was bound and determined to show them that I could. Tell me I can't do it. I will prove you wrong. I will show you that you're mistaken, because I believe, and this is real important, I can't will thwart you, will stop you, will slow you down, will turn you around and cause you to move backwards if you let it. But if you have the proper mindset, I can't will do nothing but make you that more determined to get to your goal.
Hit that button, hit that button, hit that button, hit that button, hit that button. Hey, hit that button. Hit the button, man. 6:12 a.m. in the morning. Here, rocking and rolling, baby. You know, we gotta get big. You stay asleep, man, we'll be working out. You know what I'm saying? Hey, baby, let's rock and roll. Rock and roll, baby. Wake up, man. Get ready to go. I gotta say. Yeah. Y'all a little old school? What's up, baby? Got a little new school? Yeah. Yeah. You know? Got some young bloods, you know? Got some ladies. What's up, girls? Thanks for coming.
What do you do to separate yourself from everybody else? What do I do to give myself that advantage, that edge? If everybody's out there just playing and you're exactly like them, you shape like them, you have the same speed they have, everything is the same, what's your advantage? What's your edge? To be one of the greatest athletes, to take your school's program to a level that it may have never been to, you're gonna have to have a motivation that nobody else has. You have to have a why. Your motivation has to be totally different. You have to have a why. This is all I'm asking for. I'm asking you to get a why, because apparently, there's something that's happening inside of you that does not allow you to push yourself every single time. So I'm asking you to create a why, because if you had a why, then maybe every time you went out, you just wouldn't be there in body, but you would really be there and give 120%. What are you doing for? Are you a gazelle or a lion? I want you to stop just thinking about yourself. I want you to think about your family. I want you to think about your town. I want you to think about your school. I want you to think about yourself. Remember what we talked about. I'm going to help you to separate yourself from every other player that's the same size as you. Every other player just as quick as you. Let me tell you what I know he's not going to do. He's not going to put forth 100% effort every single play. He might do it the first quarter. He might do it the second quarter. He might even do it the third, but most of them give out in the fourth quarter and they put forth 50%. And that's why Barry Sanders was one of the best running backs that ever played the game, and he would be negative 16 yards in the third quarter and still get 100 and something in the fourth. Why? Because he said all those defensive guys, the guards, the tackle, they will get tired. Their legs will give out. And just when their legs give out is when I'm going to break for the big one. You will not outwork me. I can't help where I was born. I can't help the environment in which I was born in. I can't help that my daddy wasn't in my life, but I'm grown now. What I can do is I can outwork you every single time, because you will not wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning. And I will. And guess what? When I finish doing my work, if I'm tired, I can take a nap and I'll still get up before the next man.
The number one thing that's going to change your life, the only thing that will change your life, change your business, change your money, change your relationship, is you must raise your standard.
Your life can be too big to allow yourself to play too small.
The only thing that changes our life long term is when we raise our standards. It means that all of us in life have things we want. We don't get what we want. We get what we have to have.
What you're looking for and what you're talking about and what you need is self-discipline. Now, self-discipline, as the very term implies, comes from the self. It comes from you. It comes from when you make a decision to be disciplined. When you make a decision to be better. When you make a decision to do more and to be more.
Well, I think the one thing that discipline definitely does help you with is it helps you get things done. And when you get things done, when you actually do things, You have more success.
Make some choices. With new choices, you're going to get new results. With new results, you're going to get transformation.
When you're no longer willing to tolerate something, that's when your life changes.
Develop the habits. You've got the brain power. You've got the energy. But develop the habits of success.
We know that one of the things about high achievers, they all have goals. So literally, without goals, you're directionless. You will be used. See, people without goals get used by other people who have them. People that don't have goals work for people who do.
But you know about Michael Phelps? What allowed him to be able to push beyond that moment is his rituals. Go study the guy. Most people who swim have these unbelievable workouts. He does 2 and 3 of those workout sessions a day. All the other swimmers in the beginning thought he was insane. You can overtrain, you can't do that, it's not physically possible. But he had a standard and the rituals to back it up.
If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. There are always gonna be ups and downs, but I think it's really how you really, you know, get back on your horse and keep going forward. And I think the biggest thing that I've always said is never give up. And I never have, and nobody ever should. If they want something bad enough, they'll get it. They have to work for it. Yeah, it's not going to be easy, but if you want it bad enough, they'll do whatever it takes to get there.
If you look at great athletes, for example, it's not that they were naturally talented, whether it's a Kobe or a Michael Jordan or a Federer. It was the quality of their rituals.
If you think you can make a difference, it requires commitment.
The pro goes to work, and it doesn't matter if you're sick, doesn't matter if you have kids, it doesn't matter what you're a pro, and you go to work, and that just, it puts it in your head that this is what I do.
If you don't do the work steadily every day, like an athlete going to the gym and practicing, if you don't do the work, if you don't act on the ideas, if you don't integrate them, if you don't show some self-discipline, no idea will work unless you do the work.
Everyone in the world has a list of things they think they should do. I should lose weight. I should work out. I should work harder. I should. And then you know what? What changes people is when your should becomes a must. When suddenly the thing you said should happen has to happen. That's when human beings change.
Unless you take some new action, unless you start thinking some new thoughts, unless you start having some new conversation, unless you have the guts to clean out some of the things that are not working and install some of the new rituals that will work, nothing will change.
The road to success is through commitment and through the strength to drive through that commitment when it gets hard. And it is going to get hard, and you're going to want to quit sometimes, but it'll be colored by who you are and more who you want to be.
Failure is not an option. When you go into it, I want you to go into everything you do as if failure is not an option. All right? It's not a but. It's not a label. It does not exist. You can do it.
You're not done. Don't let nobody steal your dream. I used to ask myself, can I do this? And something said within me, you're the one. You're the one.
If you want to be great, not good, not also grand, not second, not third, if you want to be great, the very best at what you do, obsession is a necessity. Once you have that magnificent obsession, once you question impossible, the two keys, then when somebody like that tells you can't do something, you have chosen the wrong one to tell something like that to. I will show you what I can do. I will turn your I can't, I will never, I won't, it's impossible. I will turn it around and I will show you that I can do anything.
I am the only problem I will ever have. And I am the only solution. I am the only problem I will ever have, and I am the solution.
You can't be serious.
It's going to be impossible.
It's impossible.
It's necessary to know that everybody won't see it, that everybody won't join you, that everybody won't have the vision. It's necessary to know that, that a lot of people like to complain, but they don't want to do anything about their situation, that you are an uncommon breed. You know, you have to know within yourself that I can do this. Even if no one else sees it for me, I must see it for myself.
If you want to be the best at that, if you want to reach the pinnacle of that, you must be. There's no way around it. You have to be obsessed with obtaining that. Greatness in any field, greatness cannot be achieved without obsession. People will tell you obsession is a bad thing.
It's possible for you to live your dream. It's necessary that you associate with winners, that you work your system, that you are relentless, that you never give up. It's you. You've got to take personal responsibility to make it happen. See, sometimes we can't say, I can do that. But what we can say, that it's possible that I can have my dream.
It's past possible, meaning that all you gotta do is start. Because if it's past possible, as soon as you start, you know you're gonna set records. You know you're gonna take it to the next level. You know what's gonna be that you're going to do what's never been done before.
If you're willing to do a little bit more than the next, if you're willing to stay up just a little longer, sacrifice just a little bit more.
The journey is not easy. Before you start that journey, mentally, you must fuel yourself with the right reasons, the right fuel to sustain the entire journey.
We all have the ability to do anything.
You can have it. You can drive it. You can win it. You can fly it. You can have it.
Impossible, baby, is nothing. You gotta believe in yourself. You gotta believe in your dream. You gotta believe one day it's gonna be your moment. One day you gonna own the moment. Listen to me, impossible is just a big word.
Well, I think that the number one thing is you have to have a very clear vision, a very clear goal of where you want to go, because only then you will get there. You can have the best airplane or the best ship in the world, but if the captain doesn't know where to go, he will just drift around. If the pilot does not know where to go, he will just drift around with his plane. So it's, I think the key thing is that we know where we're going. And that you're very passionate about that. And you see it always in front of you, the goal.
To thrive in whatever you do, please understand your terrain. Know what your target is. Don't guess it. Be as clued up as the next man, because that's your petrol, that's your fuel to get you moving. If you don't know where you're going, what your targets are, you're never going to get there, period.
And the other thing that's important is that you got to shoot for the top. You got to go and really have big goals and think big, because then you're going to get big. Then you're going to go and achieve big things. That is the most important thing. You know, we don't achieve big things by accident.